I won't be surprised if you didn't know much about Jean Tierney. Not many people do, despite being one of the greatest film and stage actresses that ever lived. In today's video, we are going to be revealing some of the juiciest secrets about Tierney's life and career. You might want to stay tuned for this. But before we proceed, quickly hit that subscribe button to subscribe to our channel, especially if you are new here. You can also leave a comment in the comment section telling us you subscribed, and we would try as much as possible to reply to you. If you're done with that, let's get right into it. Number 1. She was born in New York City. She was born in Brooklyn, New York on November 19, 1920, and was named Jean Eliza Tierney after an uncle of hers who had died young. Born to Howard Sherwood Tierney, a successful insurance broker of Irish descent, and Belle Lavina Taylor, a former physical educator tutor, Tierney grew up in all the luxury she could have ever wished for. She was the middle child, with an elder brother, Howard Sherwood Butch Tierney Jr., and a younger sister, Patricia Pat Tierney. Due to the fact that she came from an affluent family, she had the opportunity to attend some of the best schools in the country. She also attended one of the finest schools in Europe, Brilliantmont International School in Lausanne, Switzerland, where she became fluent in French. She was a lover of poetry, publishing her first poem, titled Night, in the school magazine, and continued to write poetry all her life. Number 2. Her parents didn't support her acting. When Tierney was 17 years old, she took a trip with her family to the West Coast, where they took a detour to the Warner Brothers Studios to see a cousin who worked as a director on the set of historical short films. This is where she caught the attention of the renowned Anatole Litvak, a Lithuanian-American producer, screenwriter, and director, known for his numerous works in various countries and languages. Anatole was captivated by her beauty, her crystalline green eyes, light supple skin, and prominent cheekbones that were usually common amongst the aristocrats at the time, and had suggested to Tierney that she become an actress. He was even ready to get her a contract with Warner Brothers immediately, but her parents were against it, mainly because they wanted her to take her position in society and because the salary was somewhat low. Well, if you are going to employ the daughter of a rich man, you might as well pay her according to her status. Number 3. Her father was her biggest fan. Tierney, being the obedient daughter she was, turned down a contract with Warner Brothers to fulfill her parents' wishes of her taking her position in society. But she quickly got bored of that lifestyle and decided to take up acting, as the director had suggested. Her parents finally caved in and agreed with her and sent her to take acting classes at a small Greenwich Village acting studio in New York, where she became the student of Benno Schneider, an accomplished actor and director, and then later became the pupil of the seasoned Broadway producer and directors George Abbott, who was instrumental in getting her a part in a Broadway show. Due to her family's status in the society, her father didn't want her entering Hollywood through the back door, and thus did everything in his power to make sure his daughter had a successful career. He once said, "If Jean is to be an actress, it should be in the legitimate theater." He even went as far as establishing a company called Belleteer, whose sole purpose was to fund and promote her acting career in the best way possible, an entire company. Number 4. She starred in a Broadway show at the age of 18. At the age of 18, most people are yet to figure out what they want to do with their lives, but at the age of 18, Tierney was done with acting school after studying under some of Hollywood's finest and was ready for her first role as an actress for legitimate theater. Her Broadway debut was in 1938 in the play What a Life, where she played the almost insignificant role of a water carrier. Despite she doing almost nothing, her beauty was a refreshing presence and she received amazing reviews. A critic from the Variety magazine stated, "Miss Tierney is certainly the most beautiful water carrier I've ever seen." The following year, she starred in two major Broadway shows, and the reviews were mind-blowing. For her role in Mrs. O'Brien Entertains, a New York Times critic described Tierney's performance as very pretty and refreshingly modest. The second was Ring 2, to which a theater critic with the New York Herald Tribune wrote, "I see no reason why Miss Tierney should not have an interesting theatrical career, that is, if cinema does not kidnap her away." Number 5. She struggled with health problems. Tierney was a known chain smoker who smoked pretty much all of her adult life. She started smoking after the screening of her first movie to lower her voice because she felt her voice was too high-pitched and she sounded like an angry Minnie Mouse. However, she got addicted to smoking and it soon became a part of her life. She also struggled with bouts of manic depression due to many sad events in her life, The major one being when she gave birth to a mentally disabled and deaf daughter. It was in 1943 and there had been a rubella outbreak. She got infected when a fan broke quarantine routine and infected her while she was pregnant, causing her to transmit it to her unborn child. The child, Daria Cassini, was institutionalized most of her life, but she died at the age of 66. Tierney's depression was so severe, she was in and out of psychiatric hospitals for a long time and received 27 shock treatments, which she absolutely detested. She fled the facility one time and was a vocal opponent of the practice of shock treatment. Number 6. She was married twice. Considered one of the most beautiful women of her time, several men sought her attention, including Howard Hughes, who failed to win her heart because she was neither attracted nor intimidated by his wealth like some girls would. She did, however, enjoy a short stint with John F. Kennedy before he got into politics, but ended it because he told her he couldn't marry her. Prince Ali Khan was also her companion for a while, but his father, Aga Khan III, opposed their marriage. She did, however, get married to Oleg Cassini, a fashion designer whom she eloped with when she was 20 years old because her parents opposed the marriage due to his ancestral descent. Together, they had two daughters, Antoinette Dara Cassini and Christiana Tina Cassini. Her second marriage was a Texas oil baron, W. Howard Lee, whom she married in 1960. They were married until his death in 1981 and didn't have any children because she suffered a rather depressing miscarriage in 1960. Number 7. She died at the age of 71. After a lifetime of heavy smoking, Jean Tierney lost her life to emphysema, a condition she had been suffering from for a while. She was only 71 at the time of death, on November 6, 1991. We hope you have learned a lot from this video. Tell us how much you enjoyed this video in the comment section below. And remember to hit the like and subscribe buttons. See you next time.